हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर वीवी उत्तरवार फ्रॉम केके बाग कॉलेज ऑफ फूड टेक्नोलॉजी नासिक। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अनदर पार्ट ऑफ एंटी न्यूट्रिशनल फैक्टर इन लेग्यूम्स। ऑलरेडी वी हैव गॉन थ्रू टू पार्ट्स ऑफ एंटी न्यूट्रिशनल फैक्टर एंड द लिंक इज गिवन इन डिस्क्रिप्शन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू फॉलो दिस टू लिंक्स एंड देन यू कम टू द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ दिस एंटी न्यूट्रिशनल फैक्टर इन लेग्यूम्स। ओके, सो वील गो फॉर वन बाय वन what are the remaining anti-nutritional factors. So before going to NF anti-nutritional factors, first of all we'll see what is meant by anti-nutritional factor. So here I am beginning with the definition, that is the compound which present in human or animal food that reduces nutrient utilization or food intake, thereby contributing to impaired gastrointestinal and metabolic performance. Nothing but there is a presence of some chemical compounds in the legumes which are reducing nutrient utilization or food intake of body. Okay, so what are whatever we are consuming that legumes, so the nutrient present in that grains or that legumes are not easily available to our body. So such a chemical compound which are preventing to which are preventing causes some diseases to our body, means some are temporary or sometimes they are permanent, as we have gone through latherism in our second part. So it is a quite permanent type of disability in our body, so it is not easily gonna recover. Okay, so such anti-nutritional factors are available in legumes. So in first video already we have seen most of the ANF. We'll go for next portion. So the next anti-nutritional factor is antivitamins. So the presence of these antivitamins increases their requirement. The example are, antivitamin E is available in kidney beans, while antivitamin D is available in soya beans and they are heat labai. So here are some examples also mentioned, and there is a method for removal of such ANFs are also mentioned, that they are heat labile, means by providing heat to this ANF we can easily remove this type of antivitamins. So also they are mentioned, these antivitamin increases their requirement, means for getting, means use of the it is a quite important type of ANFs present in legumes. Okay, so the relatively high level of these cyanogens can be found in legumes or some in pulses. Okay, the cyanide stress amount is fairly widespread in the form of glycosides, nothing but the cyanogens. These glycosides are non-toxic in their intact tissue, but when latter are damaged or begin to decay, a hydrolytic enzyme is released which liberates hydrogen cyanide. So nothing but these glycosides, means cyanogens are present in the form of glycosides, and these glycosides are available in the pulses, in their tissues. Okay, so whenever these tissues are damaged or they are starts to decay, so what they are doing, they are releasing hydrolytic enzyme. Okay, so these enzyme, hydrolytic enzymes, they are helping for liberating hydrogen cyanide. Okay, so the liberated hydrogen cyanide is rapidly detoxified in the liver by conversion to thiocyanate, means this liberated hydrogen cyanide, it converts to thiocyanate by the help of liver. Okay, so this can be minimized our body, minimized by the body. So the excess cyanide ion can quickly produce anoxia of the central nervous system through inactivating the cytochrome oxidase system, and death can result in few seconds. So these cyanogens or hydrogen cyanide, they are converted to thiocyanate with the help minimizing it, means liver converting or detoxifying it, means they are making it harmless for the body. But when there is an excess amount of cyanide is provided to the our body, what it do, means what it does, so they are producing anoxia to the CNS, that is central nervous system, and they are inactivating the cytochrome oxidase system. The cytochrome oxidase system is nothing but it is a one step, or it is a procedure in our respiration, that is in electron transport chain of respiration process. This cytochrome oxidase enzyme, they are performing very important role, and this is continuously going in our body. But when the cyanide attacks on these cytochromes, the electron transport chain, it is discontinued or it disturbs. Okay, that's why there is a means proper oxygen is not provided to the our body, and because of that there is an instant death is can be carried out. So this is one of the type of cyanogens. It is a quite harmful to the our body. Next, toxic amino acid. So which type of toxic amino acids are present in legumes? So we'll see. Okay, so in the legume family there are two toxic non-protein amino acids that have major negative effect on animals or human that consumes them. Okay, the first one is mimosin and second one is 3-anoxyl L2,3-diaminopropionic acid, that is ODPA 32, 33, and 5. Okay, so the ODPA already in second lecture, I mean to in second part of anti-nutritional factor, we have gone through ODPA. What is it? So we have seen it in the ODPA. Okay, so we'll continue what is mimosin and ODPA and how they are affecting to our body. The first of all, we'll go for mimosin. So what is mimosin? Mimosin, the full chemical name of mimosin is beta 1,3 hydroxy 4 pyridone alpha amino propionic acid. Okay, so it is primarily used as a forage crop for feeding livestock, but its use is limited by the fact that it contains mimosin. Okay, so one of the major effect of mimosin is it stops the hair growth, and it has an adverse effect on the growth of ruminants because of bacteria can convert mimosin to the 3,4 dihydroxypyridine, which acts as a goitrogenic agent. That's why this mimosin is quite toxic amino acid to our body. And second one is ODPA. So what is ODPA? So the ODPA is non-protein amino acid, are commonly within the legume family, which are often highly toxic and are responsible for several serious human toxicosis. Among the best known is lathyrism. Already we have seen in our second part. So what is lathyrism? It is a non-progressive motor nervous disease associated with high consumption of grass peas, nothing but Lathyrus sativus. So the consumption of large amount of Lathyrus seeds in the diet often occurs at the time of food shortage. What they are doing, they are forming some injuries, that is metabolic injuries to our body. Already we have gone in lathyrism and neurolathyrism. These two are neurological diseases carried because of ODPA. Okay, also this compound, okay, so they are having deleterious effects on our bone formation, particularly in children. So there are also some evidence that the responses to the Lathyrus consumption may be sex linked, as it seems to have a major effect on young male. So such type of some drawback are present in legumes because of these anti-nutritional factor are containing or are there present in them. Okay, so these all are about the anti-nutritional factor, that is different type of ANFs present in the legumes. So with this third video, we'll stop the chapter, that is anti-nutritional factor. So if you have any doubt or query, just put it in chat box, okay, or comment in this video, okay. And for the next chapters of legumes and oils and technology, be continued with me. Like and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much, guys.